Let's go ahead and see how we can use the GRL power test suite to test the new Anker PowerPort Atom PD1. The PowerPort Atom uses gallium nitride technology, which has a lot of advantages for shrinking the power adapter size and also getting high power efficiency. The best way to check for power efficiency is to use the GRL C2 power delivery tester. So we're going to pair that tester with a GW Instek 7100 AC programmable power source. Together, these are the only two instruments that you need to set up on your bench to test for power efficiency. The 7100 allows you to measure the power consumed by the charger, while the C2 allows you to measure the power provided by the charger. And it's really the ratio between the power provided over the power consumed by the charger that allows you to measure power efficiency and see how much power is actually wasted by the charger itself. Connecting the 7100 and the C2, it's pretty simple. All you need to do is have both of those instruments on the same network as your control PC, and the GRL power suite does the rest. The first thing you need to do on the power suite is to add the C2 IP address, and here we have 192.168.1.111. We can hit the press connect C2 button to establish a connection between the software and the C2 hardware. Next, we'll just need to make sure we have the correct charging negotiation type. In this case, it's power delivery, and we're going to use a normal USB Type-C cable rather than a compliance cable, which we use for certification testing. In the third-party tools tab, we can go ahead and add a new piece of test equipment. In this case, that's going to be the Instek 7100 PSU. We can then set the IP address of the 7100. In this case, it's 192.168.1.123. We don't have to change any of the IP port numbers. That should just be the default. Once we press the connect button, we can verify that the software can connect and communicate to the 7100. We can then go ahead and set the AC power, voltage, and frequency parameters. These are the power parameters that we want the 7100 to deliver to the charger that we're testing. In this case, we'll just go ahead and use the default values that are predefined. Next, in the test case tab, we will select the power efficiency tests. These are the predefined tests which fully automate the power efficiency testing for us. Everything else is pretty easy after that. We can just go ahead and press play. We will allow the software to do its thing. The C2 will go ahead and recognize that there are four fixed voltages which are provided by the charger. The first 5-volt rail supports 15 watts. The second 9-volt rail supports 27 watts. And then the last two support 30 watts through a 15-volt and a 20-volt rail. The automation is going to sweep through all four voltage rails, and then for each voltage rail, again, sweep through four different levels of current load: 25%, 50%, 75%, and full loading 100%. The automation is also going to measure standby power, which is basically the power consumed by the charger when there's no load placed on it. While we are waiting for the power efficiency test to complete, let's take a closer look at what we can see from the software itself. The blue, red, and green curves represent the VBUS voltage, current, and power respectively that is provided by the charger to the C2 hardware. We can also monitor the actual real-time voltage, current, and power levels at the bottom, and we can also see what sort of AC input settings are used at any point in time from the 7100 itself. We can also take a look at the message view. And this is a convenient way to look at all the actual power delivery communication that goes on between the C2 tester hardware and the charger that we're testing. Rather than waiting for all the sweeps to finish, I'm just going to speed up through the rest of this video. Normally, if you were to go through the testing yourself, you could just go and grab a cup of coffee, let the automation do the rest. Once all the voltage, current, and AC input sweeps are done, you should have all the different combinations to check for power efficiency. Once the testing is done, you can go to the results tab and look at the power efficiency calculations for every single voltage, current, and AC input parameter setting. The software also automatically calculates the different limits for Department of Energy Level 6 requirements, as well as other standards such as from the COC. The software also conveniently plots out different power efficiency curves, so it's easy to see trends, and you can see how power efficiency changes for different loading conditions and AC parameter settings. You can save the entire report into a HTML file, or you can very easily export any of the graphs into images that you can very easily import and save into your own reports. After running the power efficiency tests on the Anker Atom PD1, we ran the same tests on its predecessor, the Anker 30 watt PowerPort Speed PD30. Both chargers support 30 watts and also have one USB Type-C connector. Putting the power efficiency charts side by side, we can clearly see there are differences in the power efficiency levels attained between both chargers. In general, we see that the Anker GaN-based Atom PD1 delivers about a 5% increase in power efficiency levels versus its predecessor, the Anker 30-watt PowerPort Speed PD30. This makes it easier for GaN-based chargers to meet the stringent requirements for DOE Level 6. Plus, we get the benefits of having a smaller size using GaN-based technology.